result of the Glen State, it's actually connected fairly intimately with the death of Glen Stacy, because as I said, Dan, when he got heated questions about it at conventions, he basically, you know, put it off on me, and then ultimately told him, don't worry, she's coming back, which wasn't very likely because she was dead. But Stan said, look, I don't care how you do it, just bring her back. You can write her out again if you want, but just bring her back so they stop asking me. And I really hated that idea a lot. But with some friends, you know, just batting ideas around, I came up with the notion of it being a clone. In order for that to work out, I wanted it to tie into an existing character, so they didn't just feel like pulled out of left field. So there was a guy named Professor Warren who had appeared in a couple of issues of Spidey's book back when Ditko had been drawing it. And I came up with this cockamamie storyline that Professor Warren had secretly been enamored of Gwen Stacy, and when she died, he took cell samples and was trying to grow her into, you know, bring her back as a clone. And then to make him a villain, I always liked this thing that Stan and Steve had done where they would introduce a mysterious figure behind the scenes, you know, a supervillain who you didn't know who it was, but, you know, you knew it was somebody that was in Spider-Man's orbit, you know, the secret identity was somebody in Spider-Man's orbit. That originally was Crime Master, and then it was Green Goblin. And I wanted to do that with Miles Warren, make him a supervillain that we didn't know was Miles Warren, and I created this character called the Jackal. And one of the techniques that you use to create a mastermind villain is to give him henchmen, who are also interesting in their own right. So in order to introduce the Jackal, I wanted to create a secondary character. If you wanted, you know, one-shot character who would be working for the Jackal, which would show us how powerful the Jackal was to get hired this guy. And that character became the Punisher, who obviously, you know, became much more of a character than the Jackal has become. Although the Jackal's back now, or was back for this current run of Spider-Man stories, just ended. So, It was a situation where we did this character, you know, it evolved through